Welcome to Business Analytics Using Forecasting. I'm Galit Shmueli. Last video, we talked about performance evaluation in terms of data partitioning and mimicking the deployment scenario. In part two, we're going to talk about naive forecasts. Naive forecasts are the simplest forecast we can generate, and it's based on the idea of parsimony, or what's known as Occam's razor. This means that if you can use the simplest method that works, that's probably your best solution. So, before we create anything too complex, we want to make sure that the simplest solution is not good enough. What does it mean to generate a naive forecast? If we have the daily weather information until today, what will be the simplest forecast for tomorrow? Well, obviously, you'll take the most recent day and say, probably tomorrow will be very similar to today. So the naive forecast is just going to be your most recent value that's available at the time of prediction. If you remember our notation, it means that the case step ahead forecast is simply the most recent value at the time of prediction. Here we're assuming the time of prediction is t, so we have information until time t, and the same forecast is going to be our naive forecast for tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, the 2 days after tomorrow, etc. That is the naive case step ahead forecast. So let's consider naive forecasts in fixed partitioning versus roll forward partitioning. Remember the data that we have. Suppose that I have this monthly data here, and I'm creating naive forecasts for the training period. The black line is the actual ridership. The blue line is the naive forecast, which is simply copying the previous value in the training period. If I'm rolling forward month by month, then my naive forecasts will also be a one step back value in the validation period. This is what naive forecasting is going to look like in validation. In contrast, if we're using fixed partitioning, then the training period will look the same. But once we reach this point, we no longer have any new fresh data. So my naive forecast will simply be the most recent value that we have. And therefore, the naive forecast will simply be a straight horizontal line. What about a series that has seasonality in it, such as monthly seasonality? In that case, the simplest seasonal naive forecast is using the most recent same season. For example, if I'm trying to forecast next January, then I will use the most recent January data point that I have in my data that will be available at the time of prediction. If we have a seasonal series with M seasons, then our case step ahead forecast will be the value from the most recent same season that we have data for. Naive forecasts are very simple to generate. They're very computationally cheap and understandable. And often, surprisingly often, they are very accurate. They are hard to beat with more complicated methods. So, we definitely need to consider them as a possible forecaster. And even if we don't like them, we should keep them as a benchmark so that we can measure how much better a more complicated method can actually perform. Those are the two uses that we use naive forecasts for. Naive forecasts are something we should always create, but then the question is going to be, how do we actually measure performance? And that's where we're going in part three of the performance evaluation three videos. In the next video, we'll talk about performance charts and performance measures.